Well, the talk is about eXpert project. eXpert project, it's a project, Erasmus K2 project coordinated by University of Maribor. It's formed by 8 partners from Slovenia, Finland, Germany, Spain, and Turkey. It started in April this year, so it's very, very young. And so I try to show you just some prototype of what we try to do. The eXpert goals is to upgrade and improve learning materials already used, to translate these materials using advanced machine learning tools, and then to include the materials into Moodle and explore new models for use these materials in classroom in an international environment. Well, here I will only show you eXpert unit prototype. It will be available all of you and log in as eXpert. The info will be in the Moodle of the conference. Then the first step, it's using iTextbook. We start from iTextbook content because Maribor University built iTextbooks more than 10 years ago. And then these textbooks have animation, and mainly JSXGraph animation. And then as the animation itself, it's not enough for a student, we try to build an animation, a video from this animation. Then we build some formulas and stack questions in order to check if the students has get some knowledge from the textbook, from the videos. So this will be the what I'm going to talk. I will talk about formulas, example. I think Florian has shown everything about formulas, so I will go to the next. It's a stack example. As you can see, there is not many difference. You can appreciate the difference between a formulas example and a stack example. Students didn't appreciate this at the first sight, but then we will go deeper and we'll see a stack example with detailed feedback. And we'll see which is the real difference between formulas and stack. If there is some time, there is some questions to reflect on. Some of these questions has been in the conference from the first day, which what to use, formulas or stack, which graphical tool for formulas, JSXGraph, other or no one. And another question, it's about multilang filter in stack, mainly in JSXGraph in stack. So this is some questions I put in advance, but maybe we have to discuss this in the Moodle forum. Okay, so this is the Moodle where we are in experimenting the prototype. So you see here the e-textbook. This is an e-textbook in Slovenian, was built in Slovenian. You see the e-textbook it's where the content of the lesson is explained. They are using JSXGraph. This is JSXGraph. Maybe we can say that in this e-textbooks was where JSXGraph was used more intensively, more maybe 10 years ago. So it's good to remember this in the conference. Well, here is where the students get the information, the content. This is interactive, but we are building some new animations. This is an animation we have built. As you see, this animation has not any word. Has not any word because this animation, it's intended to be used to build a video. And the video has to be used in many languages. For example, this is in Spanish, but can be in English. Here, the subtitles are in English. At the end of the project, it will be in German and in different languages. And all of this is done using an intelligent, artificial intelligent tool created by the Polytechnical University in Valencia. So at the end of the project, all the videos will be in many languages, in many subtitles. Okay, so next is to see what it's about the questions when we check what is the the students has get. This is we have to round to the hundreds to this number, so we have to drop this. This is the lower. I think I'm doing right. And the upper. Will be here. I think I'm doing right. Okay, so normally rounding it's a difficult concept for students in primary, and we have tried to do not just the boring exercises when a student has to round numbers without one other. We have to go deeper in this. This is a formulas question. The third part is where is the code? I won't go deeper with the code because Florian has explained very clearly about this. We have created some, this is, we are using the filter because you're using this tag. We are using the extension for formulas. We have defined some variables. These variables makes the question with more randomness. Of course, here at the beginning are the variables. Variables are defined in order to make random the question. Well, here we define the board. And as there are two points, there are two variables. And the code, it's just as Florian has explained. We are using gliders in this. the most boring thing is using ticks. This strain samples is to represent less than. We will talk later about this symbol, less than, because we are using a new function in JSXGraph when these strange symbols disappear. Well, this is the code. And at the end, okay, we have some place for here, the binding function. The binding function is here. We are binding 2 points. Okay, so this is the code for the formulas. Now we are going to see the stack question. The stack question, we have to drag this number to the hundreds, it's to the 10, it's rounded to 1,085,000. And then to the hundreds. So we know it will be in this part. So could be, can be in this part because it will be rounded to, so it will be somewhere from here. Okay, now we are going to see the code of these questions. The structure is the same. First, some random variables. We put, it's not a very random exercise, but we have put two different possibilities. Then here's the code. We are using the multilang filter. Then it's like the formulas, start with the tag JSXGraph. And then the difference is we put the binding, the two things we are binding, we are putting here. Then the code, it's the same. In fact, what we do, it's we create a JSXGraph and first try it in formulas and then transfer the code to a stack in order to get a more complete question. Here, yeah, you can, maybe you can see it's the JSXMath LT is less than function. It's very useful because if we don't use it, the auto editor will destroy the code. Okay, so here it's the binding in this now it's only one binding point. You see, the structure is more or less the same. When you know how to integrate JSXGraph in formulas, you know also how to integrate JSXGraph in a stack because it's more or less the same. The difference can here, the potential response tree. The potential response tree, it's when you check the validity of the student answer and the correctness. But I will explain this in a new question here. This is a question about physics. We have to place a solid in this liquid, and the density, we know the density of this solid is 2 kiloliters, and this is 1 kiloliter. We can put in three different, at least in three different positions. inside the liquid, and of course we know this is the place because it has more density, but what is the reason this is the place? The reason this is the place, we give the forces. This is the weight force. Unfortunately, we have to use the initial word in Spanish because MLang filter doesn't work inside JSXGraph. And this is the buoyancy force, the force exerted by the liquid. We can put, think as a student and say, if this body is in equilibrium, there will be two forces acting on different in contrary directions. And then we could check. And then here it's where is the real difference between formulas and stack. Here we have a detailed feedback for each of the questions. First was about the position of the body. So the position is on the bottom, correct. The weight force was 2 newtons, so it's correct also. But the third one is the most difficult for the student. It's wrong. So I want to show you now how it's this in the code. Fair. This is the code for the stack. You see, it's very simple. Preparing this, I remained the first time we started using JSXGraph maybe 6 or 7 years ago in formulas. And one question like this had about 150 lines of code. Now you see with using the filter in formulas or using here the stack, it's only few lines. So we have made a great advances. Thank you to Alfred and the colleagues. Okay, so the problem with the stack is always in the potential response tree. We have to think a lot how to put this. This is the three. It's about the third question about the buoyancy force, and then we have put here some code. If the student answer is this and coincide with this one, it's just a point, so it's correct. If it doesn't coincide, it's not correct. The second, it's about drawing a vector, so there is two points defining the vector. Maybe I forget to show this. We have different types of binding. This is different in formulas and stack. In stack, it's more robust because we are binding a point, or we are binding a dual point, because a vector is defined in two points. Then the node three, the node two, it's okay. This is if it's incorrect, because score is one, and this is if score is one. Here's the explanation. If it's correct, This is the explanation if it's not correct. I think we leave this blank because we want to go ahead with the feedback and to give more detailed feedback to the student. Okay, so I think it's more or less a quick view of this very young project. And I think there are some questions in the chat. And on my side, I put some questions to reflect on. I think I covered my time.